Hello and welcome to another build video. This is my so-called melt or down build, which I use always for the first boss on Iron Horse. So it's basically you melt him or you die, because we don't use a revive 5 here. What I use here, I use the turret and the decoy. The turret goes for me on the left or on the right side on the boss to distract the other shotgunners that are coming, that are spawning basically on the first boss. And the decoy is for the boss himself. You put it on the train, he turns around for the first time, the shield guys turns around, so you can easily kill them with the three dreams here. Three dreams always, three players in the front. You could use the regulars to kill them, but you really need to have a really perfect build to make it work, which this is why I use the three dreams all the time in my runs on raids. It's much easier to have three people with the three dreams. Just punch the shield guys until they are down, the medic goes overcharge, and then you go for the head or for the backpack. I mainly use my this set here to shoot the backpack down, and this is just to so the boss doesn't hear. So I run Coyote in the raid mostly all of the time, because I like to buff my group, and because I'm standing really close here with this set, I'm always in 10 meter range of the boss. I use Coyote, they all get 25% more crit damage, and that's why I use it. I use 2x Providence here. I could use a third one here if someone else runs a Coyote. That is a viable option, but usually I never change. Even if there are more than three players with Coyote, it doesn't really matter for me. The 15% crit damage, yeah, okay, I could gain it by... I'm too lazy sometimes to just swap out, like look everyone in the raid. Does he run in Coyote? Do we have two or three? And change it out, like, to have it. You want to have this one here with Intimidate. Intimidate amplifies your weapon damage by 35% when you're closer than 10 meters, which we are on the boss there, because you stand in the front. And we use Adrenaline Rush on the backpack to gain some bonus armor, which will activate then Intimidate. Intimidate is only active if you have bonus armor, and Adrenaline Rush makes sure that you always have bonus armor if you're close to the boss. And this is why this build then shreds like hell. Use Fenris for assault rifle. I use my lovely P416 here, the weapon I mainly play 99% of the time in the raid, and whatever I do, I love this weapon. It's so good. I got a perfect one here with damage to tile of cover. I put strain on it because the firing rate of 750 makes it work, and I use crit chance as the mods everywhere. So what you want to achieve is like somewhere around 55% crit chance. You don't need 60. And this is just the damage what we have here. So 167, 9% crit damage, 99.2 headshot damage, which is not important on this one here. It's just to shred down the first enemy here. Fenris, obviously, for assault rifle again. The Fox Prayers for the damage to target out of cover, because the boss is out of cover. So we want that. We really need that. You can go easily with all the buffs from the raid. You can go up to like 1.4, 1.5 million per bullet on the assault rifle, and the boss will just melt. And yeah, the name melt or down comes by that, because I don't use the revive 5 here. It's either we melt the boss down, or we probably die because we don't run a healer sometimes, and there's enemies that are spawning around you will kill you then. So melt or die, basically. And that's my build here. People ask for it, so I made a video. Don't expect me like to do crazy video editing here. I don't like that. I will never do it. And I hope you like it. I hope you enjoy it. Just go for it and melt the first boss, guys. Have fun. See you on another video. Bye bye.